Hi, I'm Glenn with Independence Training.
And I'm Matt with Independence Training.
And today we're here at the AR500 Armor Shop, and we're going to be talking a little bit about how to properly fit your plate carriers and how to get them set up for success. So to start with, I'm wearing one of the Banshee carriers from Shellback Tactical, and I've got it set up with the basic pouch setup that AR500 Armor supplies when you order the full armor package with the Banshee. And what it is, you've got two AR-15 or really any, you know, carbine magazine pouch, and then you have two pistol pouches. Now, the upside of this is that it's a really inexpensive way to get your armor set up quickly to be able to carry extra ammunition. And it's really important to remember, you know, when you're setting up your carrier, that you're not putting tons of crap on it, right? Because we see plenty of that.
Definitely.
You just really, it's here to carry your armor and kind of give you the tools that you're going to need to do whatever you're trying to do, whether that's defend your home or, you know, if you're operational or you're, you know, responding, or a cop and you're responding to an active shooter or something like that. You just want to put the gear on that you need. For me, primarily, that's extra ammunition. So the downside to these kind of carriers is that I have to rip open a Velcro pouch to be able to get access to my magazine. And then when I have access to my magazine, now I've got this other magazine that's kind of just potentially floating around. If the strap doesn't completely get shut, now, you know, it's falling out, and that's obviously a problem. As far as, you know, the Velcro being not tactical or whatever, and we joke about it all the time, we don't have to really worry about tactically opening Velcro, because if we're reloading, we just shot a lot, so we're not worried about necessarily trying to always be quiet. But that being said, it is, again, a pretty inexpensive way to do things. The other downside to it is it adds a little bit more girth. So when I'm getting in and out of vehicles, or I'm trying to lay down, maybe get into a prone shooting position, if that's something that's necessary for me to do, it doesn't enable me to get quite as low. Or if I'm getting in and out of vehicles, it can you know, increase my chance of getting hung up on stuff.
Definitely. I'm also wearing a Banshee carrier by Shellback Tactical. I'm using the HSGI Taco magazines, which, as you can see, the side profile is a lot slimmer than the double mags. What's great about these is that there's no flap as soon as I need one. It's up, it's ready to go. I don't have to worry about anything else after that point. And on my left side, I have my HSGI Taco mags for my pistols. And then you can see I moved my medical pouch to my right side, which goes against the commonly accepted medical pouch goes on your left side, which is a consideration we'll get into. As you can see, I'm wearing a 2-point sling. We'll hit on that a little bit later.
Now, a really important thing to consider about putting medical kits, you know, I mentioned, hey, all I like to carry around is ammunition, but it is really important to carry a med kit of some kind as well, at least somewhere on your body, whether that's on your plate carrier, a belt, or a pocket, or something like that. We're big proponents of it, of course, in Independence Training. You know, that's a bulk of the training that we do is emergency medicine. And also, here at AR500 Armor, they have a great selection of different medical kits and even just kind of some odds and ends medical supplies. So, you know, it's definitely something you want to consider in addition to ammunition. Good to make holes. Also really good to know how to plug them. Now, AR500 Armor already has a pretty good video out there on good fit and placement, but we want to talk about it briefly here because we feel it bears repeating. Proper fit and placement of your armor, all right? When you're looking at front armor, your front armor plate should sit basically right at your clavicular line, all right? So right there at the bottom of your collarbones is where your front plate should sit. And on the back, you should basically have the exact same placement, all right? That way, when Matt raises his arms as if he was gonna have, you know, a rifle, or he was reaching up to grab something, he's getting in and out of the vehicle, he was sitting down, anything like that, the plate's not gonna potentially come up and jam him up in the chin. Also helpful for when he is raising his hands to bring a firearm up, rifle, handgun, anything like that. It comes up just slightly higher and helps to protect even more that vitals area. Now, another consideration you have to make is how tight the carrier is. You know, oftentimes we'll see people with carriers too loose because they want, you know, comfort. The problem is over time, that really starts to chafe and rub in areas you don't want to be chafed and rubbed in. And so what you want to do is you want it to be tight enough or snug enough that you can feel yourself breathing against the plate. You know, you want it to not be too tight that you can't breathe, but you want to definitely know when you inhale a big full breath, it's tight. It should be tight in your chest cavity. An easy way to check that is, you know, first, Matt's just going to take a couple big deep breaths and feel and make sure it's nice and snug and tight. Next thing he's going to do is put his arm straight up in the air, and now he's going to bend over to the left. You can bend over all the way to the right. And now he's going to twist his torso. And you want to make sure that the carrier is moving with your body. It shouldn't be shifting or moving around as you're twisting, side bending. It needs to stay with your torso. Matt's going to bend over and touch his toes. And again, just make sure that that carrier is not shifting. Make sure it's not pinching anywhere. If it's pinching anywhere, then you need to adjust your carrier or potentially adjust any equipment that you have on your carrier. So a great basic exercise to do to check the fit and comfort of your carrier is a burpee. And a burpee is good because it's going to give you maximum range of motion. Your arms are moving, your body's moving. You're checking to make sure that the carrier doesn't shift. If you feel it shift, if you feel it start to chafe at all, if you feel that the carrier's loose at all when you're done doing these exercises, then you need to adjust your fit. Also, you want to make sure that nothing on your carrier is going to fall off or fall out. So this will, you know, let you know if your equipment is appropriately placed and that you have good retention.